Hello student, welcome back. We are learning the chapter number 4, Chemical Thermodynamics. And today we are going to learn relationship between delta H and delta U for chemical reaction. You know very well, delta H equal to delta U plus P delta V, which we have learned in the previous video. At constant pressure, delta H and delta U related as by this equation. There are three different states of matter, solid, liquid and gas. And we are going to learn about this equation for solid, liquid and then for derivation for gases. For solid and liquid, delta V equal to 0. Why? Because V2 and V1 difference is negligible. Because they do not compress. Liquid do not compress or compress very very small amount. And solid totally do not compress. Therefore, delta V equal to 0. As delta V equal to 0, this P delta V is 0, means delta H equal to delta U. Second, for gases. For gases, you know very well, gases can be compressed or can be expanded. Therefore, there is V2 minus V1 value. So, delta H equal to delta U plus P delta V becomes P V2 minus V1 here. Then delta H equal to delta U plus, clear this bracket, PV2 minus PV1. As we know, for ideal gas, PV equal to nRT. Therefore, PV1 equal to N1RT and PV2 equal to N2RT. Put this value in this equation. So, delta H equal to delta U plus, instead of PV2, N2RT minus PV1, N1RT. Delta H equal to delta U plus N2 minus N1 and common factor outside this bracket. So, delta H equal to delta U plus delta NgRT. G for gases. Where delta Ng is the difference between the number of moles of only gaseous product. Remember this point, because when we calculate different numericals, you have to remember this factor. Not all the solid, liquid or gas, but only gaseous products and reactant. This delta Ng is the number of difference of number of moles of gaseous product and gaseous reactant. In this manner, you can calculate the numericals with this equation. Delta H equal to delta U plus delta Ng RT, which will be discussed in the last video. Next unit is work done in a chemical reaction. If there is chemical reaction, how work done can be calculated? Let us see the derivation. Work done at constant temperature and pressure is given by W equal to minus P delta V. Therefore, W equal to minus P V2 minus V1 in the bracket. Clear this bracket. W equal to minus P V2 plus P V1. And you know very well, P V1 equal to N1RT and P V2 equal to N2RT. So, work done is equal to minus N2RT plus N1RT. Now, simplify this equation. W equal to minus N2 minus N1 and outside this bracket RT. Therefore, W equal to minus delta Ng, difference of number of moles of gaseous product minus reactant, RT. In this manner, this is the final equation which can be used to calculate the different numericals by this equation. Now, what is the conditions? N2 equal to N2 greater than N1, delta Ng is positive. Okay, and W is less than 0. If N1 is greater than N2, then delta Ng is negative and W is greater than 0. And third condition, when N1 equal to N2, this delta Ng is equal to 0. As this is 0, the work done is equal to 0, no work done. I hope this simple topic you understand very well. Thank you.